What's going on, guys? It's the Yankee Fan, and what I'm coming guys with today is some more Call of Duty Ghost gameplay. And the video that you guys are watching right now is going to be a pretty nice chem strike, in my opinion. But we're gonna have a lot of stuff that we're gonna be talking about in this video. But of course, we have to talk about the gameplay first. So, as you guys know, it's a chem strike on Sovereign using the Honey Badger. Blah blah blah. I always use the Honey Badger, but it's a pretty good gun in my opinion. As you guys know, I don't get too many chem strikes, so when I do get one, I like to spread them out on my channel a little bit so I can still talk over some of them, even though they're really old. I did get this over winter break, but this was still a pretty good chem strike in my opinion because it was kind of slow paced until I got specialist bonus, but then I got into the spawn all of a sudden, and I literally, like, this was actually surprised me when I got it. I did not think I was actually even close to the chem strike, and then all of a sudden it just popped up on my screen because I got like a quad feed or something like that for the chem strike, and I was like, holy crap, I got a chem strike. But anyway, we're not gonna be talking about the gameplay too much in this video, so we're gonna be talking about a couple of different things in this video. Now we're gonna start by talking about the NFC championship game and the AFC championship game yesterday here in the playoffs. Now I know a lot of you guys aren't really great football fans or a lot of sport fans. You guys don't really like watching my sports videos, but this is actually something I do want to talk about though, because it's actually kind of interesting. And we'll talk about that interview with Richard Sherman in a little bit, which is why I really wanted to talk about this. But it was still a pretty good AFC and an NFC championship game. I really do. As you guys know, I make prediction videos talking about them, so I think I did pretty well. I did end up losing the second game, but it was still a pretty good game. But anyway, now let's get into this whole thing with Richard Sherman. If you guys don't know who Richard Sherman is, he is the cornerback for the Seattle Seahawks, and he likes to talk trash. He's a trash talker. He always has been like that, and I haven't really liked that, and I really don't like cocky people at all, and that's exactly what he is. That's kind of why I don't really watch, like, competitive Call of Duty at all, because everyone is so cocky. They think they're all that. Honestly, you play video games for a living. You are not the greatest thing of all time, so don't start getting really cocky. And the same thing with Richard Sherman. I hate when people are cocky like that. You're not greater than everybody because you can get an interception. You're not the greatest football player ever. I don't really care if I get hate for it either, because I just don't like people like that. You need to, like, honestly, if you look at the Yankees, which are the baseball team, they are the most, like, the team, if one person is cocky on that team, the whole team pretty much comes up to them and kicks them in the ass, because you cannot be cocky when you're on the Yankees. You cannot be cocky at all. And a lot of New York sports teams are like that. That's why I really like a lot of teams from New York. And the New York Jets are a little cocky though, which is kind of annoying sometimes. And one of the reasons why I kind of don't like that's one of the things I don't like about Rex Ryan, because he lets the players be really cocky. But there's a difference from being confident and cocky. And I feel like there's a lot of people that I like to watch that are confident and not cocky. But if you're really cocky, that just annoys me. Now, if you guys don't know exactly what I'm talking about with Richard Sherman, he pretty much called out Michael Crabtree in an interview yesterday, because I guess he was mad that Crabtree was mad that the game was over and they're not going to go to the Super Bowl. So Richard Sherman went up to him and tried to shake his hand, which, why would you do that? If the game is already over, do that at the end of the game, not when you're in the heat of the moment after you got the nice interception. So don't go up to him and shake his hand after that. You need to know a little better about that. So he went up to shake his hand and then he shoved him in the face, and then Richard Sherman went up to, like, all the 49ers teammates, and he was giving them this choking signal, like they choked the game or something like that. So, and then that does not need to be in the game. I really hate when people are that cocky. And then in an interview after the game, he was screaming it at the woman who was interviewing him, saying that he's the best cornerback in the league. Don't ever try something like that to me again. I'll destroy you or something like that. And he was pretty much just destroying that. Like, look at Darrell Revis. Now, I really do not think that Richard Sherman is the best cornerback in the game right now. Darrell Revis has to be the best cornerback. He's honestly one of my favorite players. Unfortunately, he's not on the Jets anymore. He went down to the Buccaneers, but he's still one of the quietest guys you'll know. I actually met him at an airport once, and he's one of the quietest guys you'll ever know. And I really like people like that, because it's you don't talk, you just play on the field. Antonio Cromartie, who's another cornerback for the Jets, he didn't play that well this year, but he's still a really good cornerback. Now, everyone always talks smack in football, and they always talk right to him, and he just brushes it off and keeps going and does what he does. That's the people I like to see. I don't like the people that always have to talk the talk and then they have to walk the walk, because I really want to see one day someone that's really cocky just get completely blown out. And that's why I'm really going to be rooting for the Broncos in the Super Bowl this year, to see them just blow out the Seahawks, because I really hate people that are that cocky. That's actually why that's why I don't watch competitive Call of Duty, because everybody there is cocky. They're always talking smack, and it's just annoying, and I really don't, that's, none of that stuff needs to be around, and I don't need to be around any of that either. So just leave being cocky out of the game. Leave being, like, I don't know what it is, but it's just really annoying. That stuff doesn't need to be around, and I just hate people that are like that. So anyway, let me know what your opinions are about people being cocky, because honestly, cocky people just Why are you being so cocky? Why? What is the point of it? What are you trying to prove? Yes, you're a good football player. Yes, you're a good Call of Duty player. Yes, you're a good baseball player. You don't have to be cocky about it. Honestly, that's so annoying. I really hate people like that. So anyway, if you guys did enjoy the video, make sure you drop a like. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. I'm really sorry for ranting about cocky people, but it kind of just got to me after seeing that interview. I don't understand it. So anyway, leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day, guys. Peace.